So Jed went to jail for killing a cop. Not just any cop, but Officer Carmichael, who was a very popular officer. A person who'd lived in Greendale for his whole life, as much as anybody could remember anyway. He left behind a beautiful young bride. Bunch of secrets and a lot of good friends. Jed was sitting in jail being harassed by the devil, who, much to Jed's surprise, looked a lot like him. Except for his clothes. Usually I forget to change that one, but I just almost forgot to change it this time. Carmichael's wife, the bride, was at home sleeping while two of her friends, her best friends, were going through the house, going through Carmichael's things for her, trying to remove certain things that were bothering her. She could only handle so much memories. She was just adjusting. It wasn't that she didn't love to see all those things, she just couldn't handle it. So her friends were helping her.
Silk scarf and a napkin hidden in a drawer, $200 in an envelope labeled Lenore. Maybe she shouldn't see this, she should never know, said the widow's best friend. Just take it and go. I'll give her the money later. Say it was in his shoe. That way she'll never find out. That'll do. Carmichael was a credit to the force in everything he did. It's like we got a big hole in our side where he fit. If any of you officers would like to say a word, now would be the time to be heard. Thank you, Chief. I sure would. Carmichael was a partner of mine. He was always very careful, and he played it straight down the line. One by one, the officers spoke, and the service drew to a close. He had no living relatives, but his wife never showed. She just couldn't face the men. They all understood. They got in their cars and drove home as directly as they could. Carmichael, you asshole. The new widow saw beneath her veil. Shot down in the line of duty. Is that how justice never fails? I wish that things were better when we said goodbye today. But we had our share of good times, though. Remember, hey, Mr. Las Vegas, he used to be so cool. We met Wayne Newton down at Pebble Beach, and you acted like a fool. We just couldn't stop laughing. It seems so funny to us. We left our luggage back in the room and almost missed the bus. That was a great vacation, maybe the best of all. But goddammit, Carmichael, you're dead now and I'm talking to the wall. Got back to normal. Carmichael was replaced for 1 year nobody parked a car in Carmichael's space.